Check me out, son.
Okay, so I'm packing. No, this is the day before the day. I leave yesterday. Wait, what the fuck? What the fuck am I talking about? Okay, so my nose, there's a problem. I sound a little bit like Pop Smoke with a lisp. We live and we die. The day before I leave, and obviously like every other fucking teenage idiot, I'm packing the day before in hopes to get ready. But yeah, I do have a venereal disease.
We doing daredevil dandies on these mics. Peace out to the whole hyro who's puffing on the hydro. Here, done, we moving how we like. Since the days of rockin' hollows, we keepin' things a pyro. Fire, as we move with zeal and desire. Got a hip-hop plan, hope you can fly ya. Some be having tunnel vision, but my sight is real, real broad. Cause I can't afford to miss that call. Making moves, not movies, as we get on the ball. And we keepin' things covered like a female shawl. When I watch hockey, yo, I just look for the brawl. Quest.
But how would you like to not have it? I'm sure someone out there would love to fuck a potato. Fucking bitch.
As Alex Jones once said, I'm not usually gay, but I want to run my fingers through your hair. I'm still trying to figure out classes. I've showed up late to at least a fourth of my classes. All morning classes I canceled. I'm not a morning person, so I thought maybe I could be like on my rise and grind. But I'm not. Last night I stayed up till 3 a.m. Not much going on right now. Like, I didn't just move like from Ohio to New York and I'm trying to like figure myself out. At first I was like scared. Like, I'm not gonna lie, at first I was scared. But honestly, like, I hated Ohio so much that I was like, that when I got here and I realized, I was like, oh, but I hate Ohio, so. And that's made it like much better. No, one time it got so late that I started watching Jordan Peterson. I think a lot of people are scared to move away from like their hometown or where they used to live out of fear of loneliness. But I don't think loneliness was like ever something that I had to learn not to fear it, because like in my like adolescence, I was very like lonely and I was very, I was very isolated. Like, I was a really isolated child. So for me, like, that never bothered me. It just doesn't really scare me. And I think I've used that as a, like, something that's really helped me in my life is now, I think, like, a deficit to me and just, like, not a good thing for me, because it like, being alone is good. Like, knowing, like, it is a very important skill to have, is to be alone, to, like, to know it, to be able to be alone with yourself, to be alone with your thoughts. Like, it's a very, very important skill to have, but at times it can become, you kind of jade yourself up, or you like block yourself in and you build these barriers around yourself, and you're like, and you get so obsessed with like your solitude and so obsessed with like being okay with being alone that you like are missing out on like the importance of like others. I kind of took away parts of myself that needed other people, and I just started to kind of not care. I just started to not really care about like having people around, so I never really tried too hard. Like, at a certain point, I never really tried hard to like make friends because I didn't care anymore. I was like, I really don't need it. I mean, I think you do need it though, as like a human. Like, to live longer, you need good friends. I always like had like a good friend, you know what I'm saying? But I think also just meeting people and knowing people and getting to know more people. And that's what the TED Talk actually was talking about. We meet people every single day and we're like, and we assess them and we're like, is this person valuable to me? Is this person this and this and that? And we determine to talk to one another based on the value or based on if somebody is like us, instead of just talking to people just to gain knowledge outside of ourselves, because our perception is so limited. But talking to people is literally widening the horizon and widening our limits. That's my piece, and I'm gonna show you guys my room now.
Okay, here's me. Here's my desk. It is messy right now. I am not going to clean it. Here's my bed. Here's hats. Here's this. Here's that. Here's the fridge. Here's my window. Here's a fan, here's books. Here's a closet, which is all mine, which is nice.
But also, that means my shit's gonna be ruined. Rack. Here's clothes, hoodies, boots, flea bag mug. Alright, that's it. Shucking and jiving. Keep it moving, yeah, yeah. Keep it moving, yeah, yeah, to the K-I-M. Keep it moving, yeah, yeah, to the K-I-M. I ain't got no time for shucking and jiving. Hip-hop, a way of life. It doesn't tell you how to raise a child or treat a wife. I verbalize over rhyme friendly. That puts a listener in a frenzy. So pop me in your Benzie. You dig it? Get with it. Or get your melon slitted. If you ever try to combat Sir Walter Moose King, we got the illy teen that does. Thanks for watching. Love you. Bye. Doesn't even sweat the gleam or glamour. We think it for your ass like break the hammer. Man, we rockin' joints like the Who or Santana. Keep it jams packed in, hotter than Havana. Positivity is the key in the lock. Put your hand on it, turn it to the right eye. We doing daredevil.